These scratch marks went that way. They're on that jigsaw box. Yoink. Hey guys, Skinny here, and today I've got a build for you. In this one I'm showcasing what I call the Objective Overlord Pig build. The idea behind this build is you swarm the survivors with so many objectives that they need to keep track on that gens become an impossible task to deal with, and either you just slow the game down to a crawl because they're too busy doing everything else, or they push through, they do the gens, and then the green add-on comes into effect and you snowball some really nice RBT kills. For those who don't know this green add-on, because I don't think many pigs actually use it, it's the annotated plan. What this does is it will give every bear trap an extra 10 seconds to the timer, so from 2:30 to 2:40, I think. That's 2 minutes 40, not 240 seconds. And as well as that, whenever they complete a gen, 10 seconds get took off any active timers. So the idea is that they do a gen, the timer activates, and then any gens after that, whilst it's still on, 10 seconds get took off until eventually snap. It's my favourite add-on to run with pig. I think it's really, really fun. It's got a few downsides, though, but I'll cover those during the match. But that's just one part of the build. The overall rest of the build is that, you know, you use plaything to give them something to do next to their trap, so they'd have to sort of make a judgement call. Do I go and do the trap, or do I go and do the plaything first? I really don't know. And then eventually, whenever they do the play thing, you roll around into Pentimento, which is yet another side objective they have to take care of, especially because that repair speed just completely obliterates the idea of gens. Running something that stops people from doing gens is a little bit counterproductive to the green add-on, considering you want them to do gens to get rid of those 10 seconds, but interestingly enough, it's a fun combo where you kind of just lock them into this stalemate, and pretty much in sore fashion, you make them make a choice. Do they do gens or do they do the totems? Which one do they rather do? Do they want to get out of the game and potentially risk killing their teammates by doing the gens and, you know, speeding up the traps? Or do they do the totems and deal with the crawl that is the amount of objectives, but eventually, you know, you run out and then they can actually complete it? Got two games in this one for you. Hope you guys enjoy, and thanks for watching. Wreckers. Okay then. So the goal of this build, if I haven't already mentioned it in the intro, is to assault the survivors with so many objectives that they have to do that they cannot physically do gens, because there's just that much that they need to try and keep up with. And although that's kind of counterproductive to the green add-on, the idea is that because the green add-on gives them an extra 10 seconds, but they've got so many different things they need to do, that extra 10 seconds will effectively be null and void. For those of you who don't know what the green add-on does, it takes 10 seconds off of any active bear traps whenever a gen is done. It's literally my favourite pig add-on, but it has a lot of downsides to it that makes it not worth running for most pig players. Because number one, it tells the survivors that you've got it. Whenever they do a gen, a little icon pops up in the corner to let them know. And also the fact it gives them an extra 10 seconds, which it doesn't need to do. If it didn't give them 10 seconds and it didn't tell them that you've got it so that they didn't, you know, actively not do gens, then it would probably be one of Pig's strongest add-ons. But I still consider it my favourite. Oh god, protection hit city. This happens all the time when I play Pig, I hate it. It makes Planar miserable. I should have camped that balance so she doesn't get to do that. Good though, I've got three people injured. No downs though, I need someone down before Corrupt, man. David's here. Dead hard? There it is. Asking you shall receive, there's that down I was after. Don't get too cocky, Fang. So that's the first play thing, and that should lead into... They're going to do that gen, which is perfect for me. Yep. His ramp, his tap's active. Ugh. Let's just loop this normally. He's still got the extra 10 seconds though, so... Until they do another gen. She's moving away, so they can get the save. Yeah, she left. It looked like she was doubling back, so I've just killed any distance I could have gained from that. But now David's got a plaything to deal with and his trap. Which if they do another gem will be missing 10 seconds. And should effectively feed kills with RBTs by giving them so much to do. I'm going to drop on that thing. She's taking too long to get. They're wasting time healing him, so the extra 10 seconds is completely gone. Spent doing nothing. You really shouldn't have committed to that. I don't want to put her there because there's a box right there. And then hopefully when they have enough playthings cleansed, I can then start using Pentimento. So the idea is that then they have to go and do the playthings, which then turn into Pentimento. So they have to do 90% of totems last, like twice. And like, also then have that box trap to deal with. You're gonna dead hard here. Nope. So I think next down I'll ease it on the bear traps a bit, because I've only got two left and we're at four gens and there's not a single player Pentimental up yet. Someone's totem's there. There's the first. Literally the one I just saw. And Nia's just finished searching that. I don't want to light Pentimental too early. There we go, two active traps. Still 10 seconds to go, and Nia's searched one. I did vault it, damn. There's only one of them able to save right now, because I'm chasing this David. I'm quite sloppy with my M1 killers because I haven't played a lot of just basic M1 killers in a bit. Get a free hook out of her there. She never finished searching that too, so if I can take her away, I can make her waste more time having to walk back to this to do this same box a second time. I'm going to try and get her on that hook, which I think I'll get away with. Yeah, I don't play many M1 killers because my mains are, you know... Ooh, 10 seconds. My mains are... Trickster, Pinhead, Light, which aren't really M1 heavy. So I'm quite sloppy with my M1 killers since I don't play many of them and haven't played most of them in a while. So let's pop that Pentimental to slow them down a little bit. Feng and Nia are running low on timers. This David's good. Oh, what the f... I'm suspecting one of them's going to die to their bear trap. Dead hard for the window, of course. Probably the Nia, because she's had it active for slightly longer. That was so obvious that he wasn't going to do that. See what I mean? Sloppy with my M1 killers. They've... any means that. There we go. If that's not Nia's box, she's got, like, them two to still do, and she's had to waste time doing that box twice, so... We've still got Penty up. Ah, oh, no, she got it off. Feng, though. Kill this Nia now and I'll be one up on the thing. Fuck. Dead hard. Back for the window. No. So I got at least one out of the game now. I haven't seen this other Nia all game, I don't think. They're just pushing through that gen. Oh, Fen got a trap off. Well, with Pentimental, that's going to take them a bit. I know there was the other Nia here. There's Fang. You seem to enjoy that trap thing. Here, have another one. David was going for a pallet save there. I've backed up too far from the hook. Don't worry, you're just dead hard. If the other Nia finishes the gen, I was going to say, if she finishes the gen and activates this guy's trap, I'm backing off and switching to her, and then leaving them to deal with their traps. Because David's by far the strongest one of the team. Although the fact I've not seen Nia all game does make a difference. This guy's dead if I hook him now. Waste of a trap, but may as well. There's only Nia and Feng in game, and Feng's got a trap to deal with. They have just cleansed the totem, so why can't I see the Pentimental? Is it being hidden behind a box somewhere? Yes, it is, because it was next to here. There's Feng. I could only get two. They must have never set off the other playthings. Because they must have cleansed all the dull tomb. Oh, they can't have cleansed all the dull tombs. Oh, because I killed... Yeah, I've killed the other two playthings, that's why. I only really use this perk on pig, so... And I basically don't use Pentimental on any killers. Because I don't use hexes. Hell, I got disorientated. I can't tell if she did or didn't dead hard. Now Feng has to come and get the save with an active trap. She's all the way over there. I'm gonna do that so she doesn't hear me. Of course I haven't got another plaything, because I haven't hooked Nia. That's the first hook on her. She's on orange timer. Game over. I didn't get the greatest value out of my perks to show the build off there, but hopefully the idea is clear that, like, it's too much to balance with. They will still get a fair few gens done, but that's kind of the point, because you want the green add-on to actually do stuff and pressure the people with their traps to do more and give them less time. And I think running creative gears with this add-on is the best, because it makes them spend... Just on the first box, it makes them spend that 10 seconds that it gives them. Because it makes them take like 12-ish seconds to search a box with Crater Gears, I think. Alright, we'll do another one, and hopefully we can get a little bit more value. Not that that game was particularly weak on value, it just wasn't the greatest on value either. Oh, what a coincidence! Is this an offering? No. Well, Piggy's home. Oh, well, there's no point in crouching because that person has literally just seen me. Hello. I'm going to leave her because she's another med kit and I want to play hit and run. The other dude's got to be close by. Yeah, there you are. Doing a totem. That's below me. That's a good thing for Pentimental. Thank you, Feng. We'll light that up later when I need it. Right now, it's too early to give the game up that I've got Penny.
want to do that when I've got a couple totems to light and I can sort of cycle through them. Or have, like, you know, two or three up at a time. Just do that to force the pallet drop. Is she going down there? No. You're here. Let's keep the injuries coming. Let's get as many people injured as we can. And then focus on the dance. I can't be the only one who expected this, like, new blade that came with the pig tome outfit to be animated, right? All our other ones are. Well, not all of our other ones are. There's that, like, tactical blade, whatever it's called, that isn't animated. But this one looked like it would be animated, like the other Jaggedy Saw one. Not complaining that it isn't. It's still a quite cool one. Hi. Oh god, it's Elisa. I really hate Lisa's new sounds. The only downside right now is this map has 22,000 pallets and I don't have Brutal on. But a quick ambush should sort that out. Get our first drop in play. I never mentioned this in the first game, but another thing I love about this green add-on is it's one of the only two add-ons in the game since Pig's Rework that gives you an extra bear trap. So we've got three totems up already. We're not going to get much plaything value then, but we are going to get quite a bit of pentimental value. Hi. Well, that's a waste because I'm just going to hit you again. You're not going to do this, are you? Oh, Lord. Hi. Does she have BT? Do you want to kindly tell me, Yunjin? Does she have BT? She doesn't have BT. Thank you for telling me. I didn't even need to hit you to find out. You wouldn't have dead-hearted if she did. Two active traps. Got it on just at last second. She's trying to pause a timer. I would spend more time worrying about the fact that you've got an active trap on your head now instead of wasting the, like, precious extra 10 seconds it gives you. Once the next gen pops, I'll start doing a couple pentimentals. Hi. Do I get that hit? I do if you don't pay attention. She does have a medkit. Did she have that? She didn't have that at the beginning, did she? Or did I just not pay attention? Take the window. Yeah, this Jill's a bot. That's this, so many bot vaults. I won't pop a trap right away. I think I'll wait for next gen to go to do pentimental on my next few traps. I don't want to pop them right away. It's kind of counterproductive to plaything, because the idea is to have them suffer with a trap and plaything at the same time. But I don't know. It'd be burning away all my traps really early if I do that. These scratch marks went that way. They're on that jigsaw box. Yoink. I'm gonna put her on this one so she's got further to walk. Oh, it's not looking good for you two with that gen getting popped. Enjoy losing 10 seconds. And by that logic, that means that Lisa must be going in for the save, since the only other person playing was doing a gen. No, you're here. Well, now Lisa's got to go in for the save. This is looking perfect for a little head pop. Ah, she got it off. Fuck. We still have a chance with Yunjin, though, because she's missing 10 seconds and has to do that box all over again. Dead hard? No, you're going to fuck with my FOV. And I don't think I get a plaything on you because of all the totems being gone. Please don't be her box. Please don't be her box. She'll definitely die to her trap. She had a white light when I grabbed her off it, but she's missing 10 seconds. Ooh. Hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, it's a plaything. Fuck. I almost got a 5 stack penty value there. We'll do 2 for healing and gen speeds, and then I'll do the other 2 later. She's trying to escape.
She's dead.
Ah, she's dead. No, you know. Goodbye. Oh, I love annotated plan. There's the build in full action. It's too much stuff to worry about. You assault them with so many objectives, and the extra time that it gives them seems inconsequential in the grand scheme of things. Jill put herself to death hook. I'm not going to get any value out of these other two traps. Everyone else is dead on hook, I think. Maybe not Lisa, but Jill put herself to death hook. Feng put herself to death hook as well. Yeah, Lisa's the only one who's not, so I can put one more trap on Lisa, but the game's practically over. You do kind of have to be very aggressive with this build, because you need to play into it yourself. Hang on. Let's just make this even better and get full pentamental value, why not? Just to further highlight this build, just for some fun. Oh, hi, Feng. Just gonna go on, enjoy! It's not often you get that. She's healing herself. I can't believe this Lisa's still so determined to heal herself when Pentamental's up. I thought you went upstairs, I pre-swung. Oh my god, I'm such a bot. I'm such a bot with them one killers. I kind of hope I find the hatch so she's stuck with pentamental gate speeds. I can hear it. Yeah, she's got it. Still, that was fun. I can't understand why they started killing themselves on hook. It kind of took the wind out of that game and made it sort of a surefire thing, but we got value out of the build. We got a head pop with it. We got some things. I hope you enjoy the little objective overlord pig, as I'm calling it. It's quite fun. Provided you can get it to work. It's sort of hard to work on bigger maps because of the totems spreading out. Well, it's awkward because it's good on big maps to get value out the green add-on, but then you don't get much pentamental value, and then on smaller maps you don't get much add-on value, but you can get decent pentamental value. Sort of a double-edged sword, but it's fun. It's a nice little change to run this.